Hello everyone, my name is Bartley Carlson. I work with Agilent Technologies Vacuum Products Division. We're here today to give you an overview of the modern day Agilent turbomolecular pump. In subsequent videos, we will be discussing installation, startup, monitoring, and shutdown of a turbopump and how it relates to a high vacuum system. So let's begin with a quick tour of the turbomolecular pump. Turbopumps come in multiple types of flange styles, which can be connected to your vacuum chamber. The ISO flange or the conflat flange, depending on your vacuum requirements. As we work our way down the turbopump body, we get to the manual vent valve. This manual vent valve is used to slow the rotational speed of the turbo during shutdown. The electrical connection here provides power from the turbo's electronic controller to the pump motor. Here is the exhaust of the turbo, also known as the forline, which will need to be connected to a rough vacuum pump, usually referred to as a backing pump. If an additional electrical ground is required, it can be connected here. The purge port located here can be used to introduce inert gas to protect the pump bearings in aggressive applications. And finally, on the bottom of the turbo pump, you will notice several threaded holes used to mount one of Agilent's cooling kits. Okay, I hope you found this video useful. There's more videos to come. Again, I'm Bartley Carlson with Agilent Technologies.